There's some joyful giving. Why don't you go ahead and take a seat? Share, are you ready? Okay. I want to share this one thing before the dance team comes and get the audio ready, guys, and pump it up loud. Everybody with me? I just feel like we're a big, happy family tonight. We're in no hurry. We got all night. Did you know we're in a war? Did you know that whether you know it or not, or like it or not, that the devil hates you? He hates God and he hates your worship especially. This means that we are constantly in a war. Now, sometimes there's retreat, sometimes there's rest, but even when we're at rest, we're at war. Do you understand that? So tonight, we're going to give you a little picture of that, but I want to share with you something that God shared with me just a few months ago. I was walking into Cousin's Barbecue, and we had just had our Thunder on the Mountain conference. Some of you were at that. Awesome time. And as I was looking at the TV screen in Cousin's Barbecue, of all places, it's a great place to be in Fort Worth, Texas. And I was looking at the TV screen, and it was March Madness. We got any basketball fans in here? It was March Madness. Hoop! Hoops! And March Madness, if you don't know what it is, it's basketball frenzy, basically. In the month of March, for some reason, all of these playoff games happen, and it's just crazy, wonderful basketball heaven for basketball fans. And I was watching on the screen the highlights reel on a sports show, and they were showing victory celebrations, one to the next, to the next, to the next. And it wasn't like, that's cool, we won. Hey, that's cool. No, it was like 3, 2, 1, from the back. Woo, it's good. Like that. Say like that. And there were guys jumping on top of each other and rolling on the floor, literally, and, you know, pushing each other up on their shoulders and cutting the net off of the rim and dumping the Gatorade on the coach, and literally there were guys sitting back after the game going, wow, did you see that shot, man? And they were poking each other, and it was victory, victory, next game, victory, next game, victory, next game. Right in Cousin's Barbecue, the Holy Spirit spoke to me, and he said, it's time for the church to become drunk with victory. Let that soak in. Some of you have had so little to drink, you need to drink more. It's time for the church to become drunk with victory. Now, I love it when the Holy Spirit speaks like that in Cousin's Barbecue, but I'm a practical kind of guy, so I'm asking him the question, what does that mean exactly? I had never heard that before. And at the time, I was going to my son John Samuel's Little League baseball games, and I had noticed that these little 7, 8-year-old boys, you know, they're very emotional about their baseball. When they're up, man, they're up. And when they're down, they're like, we're gonna lose. Just like us. And God showed me an illustration of what drunk with victory looks like. And you know what he said? He said, if you could get those little boys before the game and look into their eyes and say, boys, I know we got a big game tonight, but I've got great news for you. I already know the outcome of the score. We win 10-2 after 5 innings. And the Lord said, what do you think that would do for those little boys' performance in the game? What do you think it would do for them? If they knew they were going to win before they even started. And the Lord said, drunk with victory is this. You have to know before you even start that you've already won. And then how are you going to play the game? Like this?
We're going to lose. We're three runs down. It's the bottom of the fourth. Oh, no.
No. It doesn't matter if we're three runs down, does it? If you already know the outcome. And the Lord started to show me lots and lots of pictures of what drunk with victory looks like. What if we began to live in this moment as if we had already won? What if the church began to become drunk with this? I said drunk with this.